miracle reside the Quran. Recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Quran are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. I praise Allah the Mighty alone, and I send the best peace and blessings upon His most beloved Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Brothers and sisters, I would like to welcome you to another live edition of your program, Correct Your Citation. With us today, Sheikh Abdul Khaliq, as usual, we're blessed to have him, and a couple new guests. We have Hassan all the way from Homs, from Syria, mashallah, who is one of the callers, by the way. And we have Abdul Rahman and Islam, or Abu Islam. He's known of both. And we have a surprise with regards to Abu Islam, inshallah, in a little bit. But without any further ado, I'd like to request Sheikh Abdul Khaliq to begin the recitation from ayah number 16 through ayah number 29 of Surah Qaf. Sheikh Abdul Khaliq, tafaddal.
A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytanir rajim. ولقد خلقنا الإنسان ونعلم ما توسوس به نفسه ونحن أقرب إليه من حبل الوريد إذ يتلقى المتلقيان عن اليمين وعن الشمال قعيد ما يلفظ من قول إلا لديه رقيب عتيد وجاءت سكرة الموت بالحق ذلك ما كنت منه تحيد ذلك ما كنت منه تحيد وجاءت كل نفس معها سائق وشهيد ونفخ في الصور ذلك يوم الوعيد لقد كنت في غفلة من هذا فكشفنا عنك غطاءك وجاءت كل نفس معها سائق وشهيد لقد كنت في غفلة من هذا فكشفنا فكشفنا عنك غطاءك فكشفنا عنك غطاءك الذي جعل مع الله إلها آخر فألقياه في العذاب الشديد. قال قرينه ربنا ما أقويته، قال لا تختصموا لدي وقد قدمت إليكم بالوعيد. ما يبدل القول لدي
جزاك الله خيرا، بارك الله فيك. Thank you شيخ عبد الخالق، may Allah bless you. ولقد خلقنا الإنسان ونعلم ما توسوس به نفسه ونحن أقرب إليه من حبل الوريد. Allah the Almighty confirms what he established via several proofs in the previous ayat, that indeed we've created al-insan, the generation after generation of the human beings. وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُهُ. And we certainly know everything that was his own self whispers to him. In the Sahih Hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, deeds are but by their intentions. إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَاتِ. No one else other than Allah the Almighty knows the hidden, knows the intentions, knows what is in the hearts. And that's why when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam questioned Usama ibn Zayd when he killed somebody on the battlefield, prior to killing him, he said, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله. So Usama ibn Zayd still killed him. And when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, how dare you kill a Muslim? He said, O Prophet of Allah, he only said it to save his life. He only said it when he saw the sword on his neck. He had killed many Muslims on that day, and he had hurt us a great deal. What was the Prophet ﷺ reply to him? He said, هَلَّا شَقَقْتَ عَنْ قَلْبِهِ. Did he cut open his heart? Did he verify that whether he really meant it, whether he was lying? He dealt with the hypocrites while he knew that from the circumstantial evidences that they are hypocrites. But he never pointed fingers to them saying that you are a kafir or a munafiq, because only Allah the Almighty knows the hidden. Only Allah the Almighty knows the intentions. وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُهُ وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ. And نَحْنُ here refers to the royal we, and we are indeed closer to him than his own jugular vein. What could be closer to you than your own jugular vein? Ibn Kathir, may Allah have mercy on him, says that it refers to the angels who are in charge of recording our deeds, the good and the bad. The following ayat will explain that there are two angels. Their job and their tasks are described as Raqib and Atid. This is the job description. These are not the names. So they record everything that we do. So that is the meaning of we are closer to him. Allah the Almighty knows whatever even you're thinking about, whatever you're thinking of, whatever you're contemplating, knows your intention. And that's why on the Day of Judgment, a person who died as a martyr in front of people, on the Day of Judgment, Allah the Almighty would ask this person, what did you do in your life? He said, I fought for your sake. Until I died as a shaheed, all of that was for your sake. Allah the Almighty will confront him with the reality and say to him, you lied. No one on earth whatsoever, not even the angels, could make the decision. Only Allah the Almighty, because He knows His intention. You've only done that so that people will say He's brave, He's courageous, and it was said, take Him to Him. Similarly, with a generous person who used to give in a charity a lot, and a scholar, and a reciter of the Quran, but he was reciting so that people would admire his recitation. He was giving a speech so that people would admire his speech. Because of that, he gained no reward whatsoever. Only Allah could determine that. وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُ وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبِلِ الْوَرِيدِ. Then Allah the Almighty says in the following ayah, ayah number 17, إِذْ يَتَلَقَّ الْمُتَلَقِّيَانِ عَنِ الْيَمِينِ الْمُتَلَقِّيَانِ. He refers to the two angels, that's dual. One on his right shoulder and one on his left shoulder. عَنِ الْيَمِينِ, from the right, and عَنِ الشِّمَالِ, and from the left side, قَعِيد. One sitting on the right and one is sitting on the left to note his or her actions. That happens once any of us reach the age of puberty. Before that, رُفِعَ الْقَلَمُ عَنْ ثَلَاثٍ. One of them is الصَّبِيُّ حَتَّى يَبْلُو. As long as you are still in your childhood and under maturity, our actions will not be recorded. Yes, we will be rewarded for whatever good we do, but the bad, we will be exempt. Then once the child reaches the age of puberty, then يَتَلَقَّ الْمُتَلَقِّيَانِ. They record everything, whether good or bad, actions or sayings. مَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ. Not a word does he or she utter, but there is a watcher by him ready to record it. And a lafz does not necessarily have to be a word. مَا يَلْفِظُ. It could be something which is not necessarily a clear word that is understood. It could be something which refers to something bad, such as uff. Uff is an expression that shows that you're upset, you're angry, you're not happy, you're not satisfied. لا تقل لهما أوف. So saying off to one's parents is a major sin. Right away, the angel on the left shoulder will record it. But also that in the hadith, we have been informed that these two angels, who their job is raqib and atid, watchful for whatever you do or you say, then they record it. Raqib is a hafiz. وَإِنَّ عَلَيْكُمْ لَحَافِظِينَ كِرَامًا كَاتِبِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ مَا تَفْعَلُونَ سورة الانفطار, chapter number 82, verses from 10 through 12. حافظين, guards, they record whatever you do or say. مَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ. So anything that you utter, even if it appears to people as has no meaning, it will be still recorded. رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ. Now, in the hadith, which is a sound hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, إِنَّ الرَّجُلَ لَيَتَكَلَّمُ بِالْكَلِمَةِ مِنْ رِضْوَانِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى مَا يَظُنُّ أَنْ تَبْلُغَ مَا بَلَغَتْ يَكْتُبُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ لَهُ بِهَا رِضْوَانَهُ إِلَى يَوْمِ يَلْقَاهُ. The Prophet ﷺ said, a man may utter a word which he does not understand nor anticipate how great is this word, but it's a word that pleases Allah the Almighty. It's a good word. يَكْتُبُ اللَّهُ لَهُ بِهَا رِضْوَانَهُ. Allah will be pleased with him until the day of judgment for one single word, such as enjoining what is good, forbidding what is bad, defending somebody is in his absence, testifying to the truth, abstaining from saying falsehood under any circumstances, the word of justice, the word of truth. And on the contrary, وَإِنَّ الرَّجُلَ لَيَتَكَلَّمُ بِالْكَلِمَةِ مِنْ سَخَطِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى مَا يَظُنُّ أَنْ تَبْلُغَ مَا بَلَغَتْ يَكْتُبُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَلَيْهِ بِهَا سَخَطَهُ إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. And a person may utter a word, he's heedless, doesn't understand how evil is such word. He's not afraid of what he says, But it's such an evil word that upsets and displeases Allah the Almighty that Allah will continue to curse him because of this word until the Day of Judgment. When this hadith was said, a lot of people zipped off their mouth. Some people used to put a stone in their mouth. Why? They don't want to talk. They're afraid if they open their mouth that they may say a word which upsets Allah. When Aisha is a co-wife was jealous of Safiya, and Safiya was a very beautiful woman, may Allah be pleased with her. They're all the mothers of the believers, may Allah be pleased with them. And she said, she pointed to the Prophet ﷺ with her hand. She doesn't mean anything other than that she's shorty. She didn't even say it. But the Prophet ﷺ said, oh Aisha, you just utter a word. It is such a bad word that if it was mixed with the water of the ocean, it would have polluted it. It would change its color. Not necessarily that you have to say it. You know? مَا يَنْفِضُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ. Then Allah the Almighty says, وَجَاءَتْ سَكْرَةُ الْمَوْتِ بِالْحَقِّ. سَكْرَةُ الْمَوْتِ means the stopper of death, the pain that precedes extracting the soul out of the body. It's very painful. In the sound hadith, Aisha radiallahu anha narrated that when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was lying down on his deathbed, he used to wipe off the sweat out of his forehead and he used to say, Subhanallah, inna lilmauti lasakarat. Indeed, death has very painful moments. It is very painful. And for the believer, this pain is to remit the remaining sins of his or hers. And for the non-believers and the wicked, it is just the beginning. And what is remaining is a lot worse, and it is everlasting. وَجَاءَتْ سَكْرَةُ الْمَوْتِ بِالْحَقِّ. Remember all of that, Allah the Almighty is telling us that there will be life after death. There is indeed a creator, and life has a reason, and there is a purpose of life, and after life there will be death. And ذَلِكَ مَا كُنْتَ مِنْهُ تَحِيدٌ. For those who denied life after death, who thought, إِنْ هِيَ إِلَّا حَيَاتُنَا الدُّنْيَا نَمُوتُ وَنَحْيَا وَمَا نَحْنُ بِمَبْعُوثِينَ. There is the only life that we're going to live and there will not be any other life after we die. This is what you have been avoiding. وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ ذَلِكَ يَوْمُ الْوَعِيدِ. الصُّور means a trumpet. And there is an angel whose name is Israfil. Allah created this angel and his duty or task is to blow in the trumpet. وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ فَصَعِقَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ. This is in Surah Az-Zumar with regards to the first blowing of the trumpet. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, how am I supposed to feel good and enjoy my life? وَصَاحِبُ الصُّورِ قَدْ إِلْتَقَمَ الصُّورِ. إسرافيل, peace be upon him, have already picked up the horn, the trumpet. وَأَحْنَى جَبْهَتَهُ. He lowered his head. He's just waiting for the command of Allah to lift up his head and to start blowing in the trumpet. فَصَائِقَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Every living creature other than Allah the Almighty, whether in the heavens or on earth, will die and will perish. Except for those whom Allah the Almighty will, such as the angel of death, Israfil himself, and Jibreel alayhi salam. ثُمَّ نُفِقَ فِيهِ أُخْرَى فَإِذَا هُمْ قِيَامٌ يَنْظُرُونَ. Then after everything will perish, Allah the Almighty will order Israfil alayhi salam to blow one more time in the trumpet, in As-Sur. ثُمَّ نُفِخَ فِيهِ أُخْرَى. Another time. فَإِذَا هُمْ قِيَامٌ يَنْظُرُونَ. Then all of them will be revived, will stand up and will get up. Those who died hundreds or thousands or tens of thousands of years ago, everyone and everything will come back to life by the leave of Allah the Almighty. يَنْظُرُونَ. Staring and gazing at what? Following the sound. Gathered to the land of gathering or to Ard al-Mahshar. وجاءت ذلك يوم الوعيد. That is the day which have been given and we have been warning you against the day of resurrection. وجاءت كل نفس معها سائق وشهيد. Number 21. Every single soul, every single soul, every person will come forth on the day after the second blowing in the trumpet, will come along with two, سائق and a شهيد. A سائق is an angel to drive him to the land of gathering, and a شهيد is another angel who bears witness either for or against that person. سائق وشهيد. لقد كنت في غفلة من هذا فكشفنا عنك غطاءك فبصرك اليوم حديد. It will be said to the sinners, to the non-believers and the criminals, to the agnostics, to the atheists, those who deny the resurrection, it will be said to them, indeed, you are heedless of this. Now we have removed your covering and sharp is your sight on that day. You wouldn't have to wear glasses to realize that this is the ultimate truth. That is يوم الوعيد. That is the day whereof warning had been given to you. وقال قرينه هذا ما لدي عتيد. And his companion of the angels will say, here is the record ready with me. In Surah Al-Isra, Allah the Almighty says, وَكُلَّ إِنسَانٍ أَلْزَمْنَاهُ طَائِرَهُ فِي عُنُقِهِ وَنُخْرِجُ لَهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ كِتَابًا يَلْقَاهُ مَنْشُورًا. In the previous ayat, we studied مَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ, ayah number 18, the two angels. And once a person dies and expires, they fold his record. And it will be hung from his neck. And he will be buried with it. Then on the day of judgment, he will be resurrected. Each and every one will come with his record hanging from his neck. وَكُلَّ إِنسَانٍ أَلْزَمْنَهُ طَائِرَهُ فِي عُنُقِهِ, in his neck. He cannot deny it. He cannot run away from it. وَنُخْرِجُ لَهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ كِتَابًا يَلْقَاهُ مَنْشُورًا, and his record will be wide open before him on the day of judgment. May Allah make it easy for all of us. لقد كنت في غفلة من هذا. It will be said to the sinners, this is what you have been neglecting and heedless of. وقال قرينه, some of the Mufassirin said, القرين here may refer to the angel who is in charge of guarding him, or may refer to القرين of the jinn, the associate of the jinn, because each and every one of us have an associate, or one of the jinn who is like a companion to him. وَمَنْ يَعْشُ عَنْ ذِكْرِ الرَّحْمَنِ نُقَيِّضْ لَهُ شَيْطَانًا فَهُوَ لَهُ قَرِينٌ. Aisha radiallahu anha asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even you, O Messenger of Allah, you too, you have a qareen of the jinn? He said, yes, even me. وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ أَعَانَنِي عَلَيْهِ فَأَسْلَمْ. But Allah have assisted me so that he have accepted Islam, or فَأَسْلَمْ يعني I feel secure from his heart. He cannot whisper to me, I'm being immune. Each and every one of us have a qareen. وَقَالَ قَرِينُهُ هَذَا مَا لَدَيَّ عَتِيد. So according to the ayah which says that the companion will be of the angel, he will say, here is the record, ready with me to submit for the hisab of this person. أَلْقِيَ فِي جَهَنَّمَ كُلَّ كَفَّارٍ عَنِيدٍ. أَلْقِيَ here is dual. It's a command verb. Allah is commanding two. أَلْقِيَ, both of you, throw in hellfire every stubborn disbeliever. Everyone who disbelieved in the oneness of Allah the Almighty. And in the hereafter. So أَلْقِيَ, the command is referring to whom? Is referring to السائق والشهيد, the two angels, one who is driving and one who is a witness. مناع للخير معتد مريب, hinderer of good, transgressor, and a doubter. So those who denied and transgressed and disbelieved in Allah the Almighty will be thrown in hellfire by the command of Allah the Almighty. It was said that the reason of this, the revelation of this verse, because of Al-Walid ibn al-Mughira, who hindered his nephews from accepting Islam. That is the meaning of manna'i lil-khayr. Not only that he disbelieved and he rejected faith, but he also hindered others from entering Islam. الَّذِي جَعَلَ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَٰهًا آخَرَ فَأَلْقِيَاهُ فِي الْعَذَابِ الشَّدِيدِ. Who is this person who is manna'i lil-khayri, mu'tadin, murib, manna'i lil-khayri, hinderer of good, mu'tadin, transgressor, murib, doubter. Who is he? الَّذِي جَعَلَ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَٰهًا آخَرَ. One who associated with Allah in worship another god. For him, فَأَلْقِيَاهُ فِي الْعَذَابِ الشَّدِيدِ. Both of you, السائق والشهيد, are commanded by Allah to throw him in the painful and severe torment. Would like to stop here, brothers and sisters, because we ran out of time for this segment. And inshallah, Azza wa Jalla, we'll take a short break. We'll be back because we have a nice surprise for you. Beautiful sound, melodious voices I'd like to share with you after this short break. Inshallah, please stay tuned.
Recite it every day and do read it loud.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back. This is a live edition, and our phone numbers are 002-0238-555-131 or 132. We already have some callers waiting on the line. Let's begin with Sister Aisha from the KSA. Assalamu alaikum, Sister Aisha.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. How are you?
Great, thank you for asking. Welcome to the program. Today we're reciting from ayah number 16 through 26, okay?
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ولقد خلقنا الإنسان ونعلم ما توسوس به نفسه.
Put a zabar on the noon. Put a zabar on the noon. ولقد خلقنا الإنسان.
ولقد خلقنا الإنسان ونعلم ما توسوس به نفسه ونحن أقرب إليه من حبل الوريد إذ يتلقى المتلقيان عن اليمين وعن الشمال قعيد ما يلفظ من قول إلا لديه رقيب عتيد وجاءت سكرة الموت بالحق ذلك ما كنت منه تحيد ونفخ في الصور ذلك يوم الوعيد وجاءت كل نفس معها سائق وشهيد لقد كنت في غفلة من هذا فكشفنا عنك غطاءك فبصرك اليوم حديد وقال قرينه هذا ما لدي عتيد.
Sister Aisha, we need to fatten the calf so that it doesn't resemble the calf, okay? وقال قرينه, okay? وقال قرينه.
وقال قرينه هذا ما لدي عتيد ألقيا في جهنم كل كفار عنيد مناع للخير معتد مريب الذي جعل مع الله إلها آخر فألقياه في العذاب الشديد.
حسبك سيستر عائشة, بارك الله فيك. Now I would like to introduce to you a very unique person, mashallah, لقد تلبلا. But let's listen to his recitation first, then inshallah I will introduce him. Abu Islam, please, تفضل.
ولقد خلقنا الإنسان ونعلم ما توسوس به نفسه ونحن أقرب إليه من حبل الوريد إذ يتلقى المتلقيان عن اليمين وعن الشمال قعيد ما يلفظ من قول إلا لديه رقيب عتيد وجاءت سكرة الموت بالحق ذلك ما كنت منه تحيد ونفخ في الصور ذلك يوم الوعيد وجاءت كل نفس معها سائق وشهيد لقد كنت في غفلة من هذا فكشفنا عنك غطاءك فبصرك اليوم حديد وقال قرينه هذا ما لدي عتيد ألقيا في جهنم كل كفار عنيد من الذي جعل مع الله إلها آخر فألقياه في العذاب الشديد.
حسبك بارك الله فيك جزاك الله خيرا. أبو إسلام used to be a singer, a very famous singer. Allah the Almighty has guided him and he quit singing, quit attending parties and music and all of that. But meanwhile, mashallah, besides his melodious voice in reciting the Quran, he also, you know, mashallah, sings beautiful nasheed. So I would kindly request him to give us, like, you know, a sample of your nasheed, please.
أما والله لو علم الأنام لما خلقوا لما غفلوا وما أما والله لو علم الأنام لما خلقوا لما غفلوا ونام لقد خلقوا ليوم لو رأته عيون قلوبهم ساحوا وهام ممات ثم حشر ثم نشر وتوبيخ وأهوال عظام ليوم الحشر قد عينت أناس فصلوا من مخافته وصاموا ونحن إذا أمرنا أو نهينا كأهل الكهف أيقاظ
MashaAllah, barakAllah fiqh. And amazingly, it coincides the subject. He says, أَمَا وَاللَّهِ لَوْ عَلِمَ الْأَنَامُ لِمَا خُلِقُوا لَمَا غَفَلُوا وَنَامُوا. By Allah, if people were to know the purpose of life and why Allah have created them, they wouldn't have neglected that purpose. They wouldn't have been heedless. They wouldn't even fall asleep. Rather, they would work hard to prepare for the day which he called it يوم الحش in your nasheed. Thank you, Abu Islam, barakallahu feek. We have also Abdul Rahman and we have Hassan, am I right? I'd like to begin with Hassan from Homs, from Syria, all the way from Syria. Go ahead and recite from ayah number 16, please. وَلَقَدَ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ولقد خلقنا الإنسان ونعلم ما توسوس به نفسه ونحن أقرب إليه من حبل الوريد إذ يتلقى المتلقيان عن اليمين وعن الشمال قعيد ما يلفظ من قول إلا لديه رقيب عتيد وجاءت سكرة الموت بالحق ذلك ما كنت منه تحيد ونفخ في الصور ذلك يوم الوعيد وجاءت كل نفس معها سائق وشهيد لقد كنت في غفلة من هذا لقد كنت في غفلة من هذا فكشفنا عنك غطاءك فبصرك اليوم حديد وقال قرينه هذا ما لدي عتيد ألقيا في جهنم كل كفار عنيد مناع للخير معتد مريب الذي جعل مع الله إلها آخر فألقياه في العذاب الشديد
فألقياه في العذاب الشديد
الذي جعل مع الله إلها آخر فألقياه في العذاب الشديد
حسبك بارك الله فيك شعيب من الكويت السلام عليكم يا شعيب
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله
يا ولد إن شاء الله hopefully next week we're gonna meet you there you know that Okay. So inshallah, hope to see you there. Okay. In Kuwait. Go ahead, ya Shu'aib. Recite from ayah number 16 to 26.
Yeah, okay. ونحن أقرب إليه من حبل الوريد إذ يتلقى المتلقيان عن اليمين وعن الشمال قعيد ما يلفظ من قول إلا لديه رقيب عتيد وجاء ذلك ما كنت منه تحيد ونفخ في الصور ذلك يوم الوعيد وجاءت كل نفس معها سائق وشهيد لقد كنت غفلة من هذا فكشفنا عنك غطاءك فبصرك اليوم حديد وقال قرينه هذا ما لدي عتيد ألقيا في جهنم كل كفار عنيد مناع للخير معتد مريب الذي جعل مع الله إلها آخر فألقياه في العذاب الشديد
ما شاء الله يا شعيب you keep getting better الله أكبر اللهم بارك أي الله bless you and your family Thank you. Jazakallah khairan. Brother Ibrahim, assalamu alaikum. Welcome to Correct Your Citation.
What?
Is he still on the line?
وعليكم السلام.
Go ahead and recite from ayah number 16 through 26, please, of Surah Qaf. ولقد خلقنا الإنسان.
ولقد خلقنا الإنسان ونعلم ما توسوس به نفسه ونحن أقرب إليه من حبل الوريد إذ يتلقى المتلقيان عن اليمين وعن الشمال قعيد ما يلفظ من قول إلا لديه رقيب عتيد وجاءت سكرة الموت بالحق ذلك ما كنت منه تحيد ونفخ في الصور ذلك يوم الوعيد وجاءت كل نفس معها سائق وشهيد لقد كنت في غفلة من هذا فكشفنا عنك غطاءك فكشفنا عنك غطاءك فبصرك اليوم حديد وقال قرينه هذا ما لدي عتيد ألقيا في جهنم كل كفار عنيد مناع للخير معتد مريب الذي جعل مع الله إلها آخر فألقياه في العذاب الشديد
حسبك حسبك يا إبراهيم beautiful ما شاء الله Just make sure, I want you to listen to وقال قرينه from Sheikh Abdul Khaliq. Sheikh Abdul Khaliq, and show him the fasl between the two halves, please. وقال قرينه.
وقال قرينه هذا ما لدي عتيد.
نعم. So according to حفص عن عاصم, you make a clear separation. وقال قرينه هذا. بارك الله فيكم. ريان from the KSA. السلام عليكم يا ريان. Are you still on the line?
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Welcome to the program.
Thank you.
Okay, from ayah number 16, please. ولقد خلقنا الإنسان.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ولقد خلقنا الإنسان ونعلم ما توسوس به نفسه ونحن أقرب إليه من حبل الوريد إذ يتلقى المتلقيان عن اليمين وعن الشمال قعيد ما يلفظ من قول إلا لديه رقيب عتيد وجاءت سكرة الموت بالحق ذلك ما كنت منه تحيد ونفخ في الصور ذلك يوم الوعيد وجاءت كل نفس معها سائق وشهيد لقد كنت في غفلة من هذا فكشفنا عنك غطاءك فبصرك اليوم حديد وقال قرينه هذا ما لدي عتيد ألقيا في جهنم ألقيا في جهنم كل كفار عنيد مناع للخير معتد مريب الذي جعل مع الله إلها آخر ألقيا في ألقيا الذي جعل مع الله إلها آخر فألقياه في العذاب الشديد.
حسبك يا ريان، بارك الله فيك، ما شاء الله. Before we wrap it up, we have Abdul Rahman. MashaAllah, he has a beautiful voice as well. And look at his sitting. He's sitting like he's a military officer. And in fact, he is. He's in the army now. Go ahead, Abdul Rahman. Recite from 16 to 26, please.
It's okay. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ولقد خلقنا الإنسان ونعلم ما توسوس به نفسه ونحن أقرب إليه من حبل الوريد إذ يتلقى المتلقيان عن اليمين وعن الشمال قعيد ما يلفظ من قول إلا لديه رقيب عتيد وجاءت سكرة الموت بالحق ذلك ما كنت منه تحيد ونفخ في الصور ذلك يوم الوعيد وجاءت كل نفس معها سائق وشهيد لقد كنت في غفلة من هذا فكشفنا عنك غطاءك فبصرك اليوم حديد وقال قرينه هذا ما لدي عتيد ألقيا في جهنم كل كفار عنيد مناع للخير معتد مريب الذي جعل مع الله إلها آخر فألقياه في العذاب الشديد
ما شاء الله beautiful جزاك الله خير
جزاكم الله خير
جزاكم الله خيرا شيخ عبد الخالق حسن عبد الرحمن Abu Islam, appreciate your participation, so brothers happy. And sisters. May Allah, the Almighty, bless you all and accept from all of us. May Allah make us from Ahlul Qur'an, the people of the glorious Qur'an. الَّذِينَ هُمْ أَهْلُ اللَّهِ وَخَاصَّتُهُ Such people are the chosen people by Allah, the Almighty. May Allah make us among them. By that, we come to the end of today's edition of your program, Correct Your Citation. And until next week, I leave you in the care of Allah. Wassalamu alaykum. ورحمه الله وبركاته
To an angel, then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation. And we were chosen to be part of his nation. He gave us a message, and that was Islam. So read this miracle, recite the Quran.